mind talking a little bit more in detail about that situation.
So that situation, basically I was out with friends for about 5 or 6 months. 6 months it was. Went into an altercation with about 15 to 20 guys. Now obviously I've been in this situation before, but I never had no training. Just a civilian, he's been in this situation. So something that I learned from coming through Dave was prior to that, in that situation, very tunnel vision, focus on the person in front of me. In that situation, I was bottled, that I had cheap shots over the back and the side. And that's the reason why my first lesson, Dave, again, in that scenario again, because he saw the holes in what I explained to the situation. And from the lesson that we learned, from the art form that we learned through Dave, Dave's art form, Breck, enabled me to think about multiple tactics and getting myself in angles, situations, to position myself away. Once I've got one person, move on, so I can focus on the next person. And that's basically a bit more about the situation. So yeah, so about 5-6 guards, come across 15-20 attackers, obviously there was bottles involved, there was belts involved. It was a normal street fight really, luckily there was no knives, but yeah, that's the reason why I came to this class, because I didn't want to be in that situation again. I was fortunate in that situation, that there was no knives, there was no guns. Next time, we knew.
We both know situations and people that have been
in
those situations that never made it home. Yeah. The situation I was talking about, the reason why I know so much about it, about those types of scenarios, is they're always pretty much the same in terms of the beginning, the middle, and the end of all of that. And it was my job for 10 years to bring that up. And due to the areas that I worked, the environment I worked in, London, it was a regular occurrence. I'm smiling about it because I don't want to do it for a living no more. I'm retired from it, but I've done the 10 years I've come out of it. I still look after a few doors in a sense of, I give them consultancy, bits and pieces like that. I've still got a lot of people that are still active dormant in the scene, the ground visit them as well. And I supply some too, but regardless of that, as I said, the very scenario that Aaron's talking about is a scenario that was in on a very regular occurrence. That's the reason why I created Rick. Because I was already an instructor, I was a certified combatant instructor in 2008. Come 2009, because of previous training ongoing with it. 2009, I become an instructor of another Krav Maga system. 2011, become a fully fledged urban Krav Maga instructor, all in the evolution. Yeah. What I realized, having been an instructor times three, and having my black belts before that, and my life experience before that, I realized, oh, there's holes in my own game, there's holes in every system. And even with a blend of all of them together, I was missing something. So I initially created Breck myself, right? Then, having used it again, knowing a way to test it in the laboratory that is a training environment, and then go and take it out there. It's been a long process, but I first showed Breck to outsiders, what I feel outside, my people outside my circle. First show that it's got to be now about 3 years, or coming from 4 years ago. Yeah, 4 years ago. Before I turned 30, I'm 33 now. So, where I'm at now is where I feel that Rex at. It's been at its best ever, obviously, it's evolved. And as it stands right now, making waves around the world, but in small circles, and that's all I need in regards to it. Other than that, it's Hydra combatives, and then above and beyond that, obviously we do urban Krav Maga history as well. I'm a senior instructor in urban Krav Maga, but we're going forward with Hydra combatives that break hard. Yeah? We also do pugilism, bare knuckle boxing, Muay Baran, the martial art of Muay Thai, a catch-as-catch-can wrestling concept that covers it all. And I've got my knife survivor as well. So.